wanted to start with sort of a global picture and then talk about how that impacts us locally. The Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change came out with a report and that agriculture itself has been identified as one of the major contributors to climate change. But it's a unique position in that it can be one of the major solution providers. Nearly half of the carbon that we've put into the atmosphere could be sequestered into the ground if we did a global transition to sustainable agriculture. How to transition the existing corporate structure into an acronym that I like to think of as a safe food system, one that's secure, accessible to all, fairly traded, and ecologically produced. It's really about understanding that food production doesn't have to just be organic, but we have to realize that it's a sort of a social responsibility.
I am focused on energy and climate, and I work for a workers' cooperative called Sustainability Solutions Group. But I think efficiency has to be part of the mix, and also focusing on quality of life rather than economic growth is a critical piece of them. So what are the basic needs and how does energy relate to these? So with those considerations, I reformulated the question a little bit to say, how can local communities in Atlantic Canada regain agency to address the climate emergency and to improve quality of life at the same time? What we actually care about is food, shelter, comfort, health, security, and electricity is just a means to those ends. And so if you can eliminate that end, then you're actually saving all sorts of environmental impact, all sorts of financial costs, and so forth. So that's the way in which I think a community needs to look at its energy system. And here's an example of a particular energy system. This is actually for Halifax. Current day, that's actually 2016. This is a Sankey diagram, which shows the flow of energy from its source to its end use. And then ultimately, how much of that is lost, it does not actually achieve its intended purpose versus how much does achieve its intended purpose. Location matters, and that's enabling people to walk and cycle as opposed to being a car-dependent community or a bulk purchase of renewable energy. Limit the use of combustion engines within a community. Undertake industrial-scale retrofits. Ensure all new buildings are net zero, so they don't need to be retrofit. And then ambitious public education.
If we were going to put our focus on one thing right now that would really catalyze a true shift in what's happening, what would that be?
I don't think we can wait for the federal government to do anything. Although COVID has shown that they're capable of turning on a dime.
What are we able to produce locally that then would not be an essential service from far away? And what are those services that we do require? Because we have the listening ears and the eyes of the majority of the population right now.
It just seems like things change because there are people who have a passion. And it's happening on our road with a woman that just moved here. And she's got us all gathered around a community agricultural initiative that could be year-round. And we have investigated ways to have big hoop houses that are with geothermal heat and producing our own food on this road, with the idea that we grow enough that we can share with those who can't buy. And it's just people that have that strong passion that they seem to change the world to me. I just wanted to throw that in there.